Let us see the immediate and intimate coverings. Outer one is the fibrous pericardium, which prevents overdistension of the heart. It is a fibrous sac fused below to the central tendon of diaphragm, on the sides to the mediastinal pleura, and above with the outer wall of two exit channels. Covering the heart intimately is the visceral layer of serous pericardium. It is also known as epicardium because of its intimacy to the heart. The other layer of serous pericardium is the parietal layer, which is formed by folding at the upper border of heart. There is a pericardial cavity between the visceral and parietal layers of serous pericardium. These can be seen, the pericardial cavity can be seen in this beautiful specimen. It is present between the visceral layer and the parietal layer of the serous pericardium. Normally, the pericardial fluid is minimal to lubricate the two adjoining layers. In some clinical conditions, the fluid may increase, leading to pericardial effusion, causing cardiac tamponade. As the increased fluid embarrasses the heart, it has to be taken out, and the procedure is known as pericardial tapping. It is usually done in the left fifth intercostal space, close to the lateral border of the sternum. It can also be tried from the left zygocostal angle. The serous pericardium contains two enlarged spaces or sinuses, oblique sinus and the transverse sinus. The oblique sinus lies on the back of left atrium between the six entry channels, the inferior vena cava, below and to the right, and left pulmonary veins to the left. Behind this lies the pericardium and the fibrous pericardium also, and still behind it lies the important food pipe or the esophagus. The left atrial enlargement occurs in mitral stenosis, may even press upon the esophagus lying behind the pericardium, and it may cause difficulty in swallowing. The transverse sinus. The transverse sinus of the pericardium lies in relation to upper border of heart behind the two exit channels. During cardiac surgery, a ligature is inserted into the transverse sinus to ligate the great vessels to control hemorrhage.